Oj, siromatske vandrarje, ne poznate ni poti svoje. Idete za žitka cilom po svete, po nevarni potaj, po velikom morje. Ne pela vas dobrota od dome, od žitka svojega vole, nego siromaštvo vas je gnalo, skrila maternoga vas je odpelalo. Daleč ste od svoje rodbine, večkrat v tihi nočaj si zmislite na dom nazaj. Skozi vam tečejo žalostni oči in ne ste je zadržati več mogoče. Na pamet vam pride domovina, kak vaša rodjena slovenska zemlja.
Slovenski izseljenci iz Ogrske so bili del migracijskih tokov, ki so proti koncu 19. in v začetku 20. stoletja vse do prve svetovne vojne zajemali visok odstotek prebivalstva. Ocene o tem, koliko Slovencev se je v tem obdobju izselilo v Ameriko, navajajo od 7 do 25 tisoč oseb. Spremni center za vstop v obljubljeno deželo je bil Ellis Island pri New Yorku. Helen Varadi Kiser se je tako spominja prihoda svojih staršev.
My mother came 1920 maybe. And pop came. They met over here. Pop came around that time too. And my mother contracted scarlet fever, she said, and was in a New York hospital for I don't know how long. But pop came on Christmas Day. The year he came, and I never forget, he said he didn't have anything. One hard salami and one orange got off the ship, Ellis Island. And I think, oh my goodness, they were so brave, you know, with nothing and just coming over here. But anyhow, they met over here and had a very happy life. But I admire them, and I have seen their names on the, oh, they call it the board of honor, their names, because I did my mother, Carolina Sipath Vadadi, and my sister, my late sister, did Pop on that board of honor. We each gave $100, and their names are on that wall. Wall of Honor, it was called. And that's so exciting when you go to see it, to think they came on the ship on the ocean, I don't know how many days, and Pop said, when he saw the Statue of Liberty, oh, we're getting near to this country, he would say. He knew he was getting close to the country, and they came here to make a better life.
Potovanje ni bilo enostavno, kajti po zakonu iz leta 1903 niso smele v tujino brez posebnega dovoljenja osebe, ki niso odslužile vojaščine, niso dopolnile 24 let ali bile v tožbenem postopku. Pri notarju je bilo potrebno uskrbeti potni list. Opozarjali so jih, da ne smejo nasedati besedam potovalnih agentov, ampak morajo imeti pozivno pismo svojih znancev ali sorodnikov. Ker izseljencem iz Ogrske ni bila potrebna v potnem listu slika, je bila možnost posojanja ali prodajanja. Potovanje iz Prekmurja je trajalo od 10 do 20 dni, včasih celo več. O prihodu je bilo potrebno plačati $25, veljalo pa je tudi potrdilo, da je znesek plačal kdo drug.
My grandfather came first in 1911, and my grandmother came 2 years later with the first two children in 1913. My grandparents died when I was like 2 years old, so I never got to talk to them about it, but I've been to Ellis Island and toured the museum there, and I know the conditions were not very good.
Večina izseljencev se je z vlakom odpeljala proti atlantskim pristaniščem, kjer so mnogi prvič videli morje. To je bil svojevrsten šok, saj so se bali neuri in potopa. Ko je ladja zaplula v newyorško pristanišče, so že oddaleč zagledali kip svobode, tik ob njem pa Ellis Island, imenovan tudi Otok solza. Bil je simbol upanja in priložnosti za milijone, hkrati pa tudi simbol zavrnitve vstopa v Ameriko. V času gradnje ustreznih sprejemnih zgradb in bolnišnice na otoku so sprejemali izseljence v jugovzhodnem kotu Battery Parka na Manhattanu. 2. januarja 1892 je center na Ellis Islandu zaživel. Takrat so začeli vse potnike izmed krovja in tretjega razreda z barko voziti direktno na otok. Potnike iz prvega in drugega razreda so pregledali na ladji. Prepeljani so šli skozi karanteno ter opravili carinski in zdravniški pregled. Slednjega so se vsi najbolj bali. Strah pred zdravniškim pregledom je bil upravičen, saj je ravno ta pregled predstavljal glavno omejevalno sredstvo države, da prepreči prihod nezaželenim osebam. Zdravniki so odklonili vsakogar, ki je imel nevarno kužno bolezen ali so ugotovili fizično in duševno pomanjkljivost ali zaostalost v razvoju, kar bi mu omogočalo normalno življenje. Če je bila bolezen ozdravljiva, so bolnika poslali v bolnišnico v sklopu Ellis Islanda. Kdor je bil neozdravljivo bolan ali kakorkoli odklonjen, je bil na stroške prevoznika poslan domov. Ostalim so dovolili vstop v dvorano, kjer so bile servisne službe za menjavo denarja, nakup voznih kart in telegraf. Vsak izseljenec je moral komisiji pokazati najmanj 125 kron oziroma $25 in vozno karto do cilja poti. Vstopna taksa pa je znašala $4. Če te vsote ni imel, je moral na otoku čakati toliko časa, dokler je ni dobil. S poostritvijo ukrepov za vstop se je tudi število odklonjenih povečalo. Po letu 1910 kar 24 tisoč letno. Po vseh opravljenih formalnostih so priseljence odpeljali na Manhattan, kjer so stopili na trdna tla Amerike. V času množičnega priseljevanja od leta 1855 do 1954 je stopilo na ameriška tla približno 12 milijonov priseljencev, med njimi je okrog 92 tisoč Slovencev. Vendar je večini izseljencev pomenil New York le vmesno postajo. S prestopom praga Amerike se je priseljenčevo ameriško življenje šele začelo. Z vlakom se je odpeljal do želenega cilja, kjer so ga čakali svojci ali rojaki, ki so mu pomagali pri prvih korakih.
My name is Shirley Messix DeLucio. I am pure Windish because my maternal grandparents, Kuchan, and my paternal grandparents, Messix, came from what they would call Yugoslavia. My grandmother and both sets emigrated from the old country 1913, 1914. My mother's mother, my Grammy Kuchan, talks about walking during the night, leaving her village, her parents sending her to America, and having to walk very far. And when she got to the railroad station to be able to go to the ship, she was turned back because she had pink eye. And she had to return to her village and sooner or later made the trek again and came to America. She was sponsored by somebody, I think in Allentown, and as she was growing up, worked in cigar factory.
Po prihodu v Združene države Amerike se je veliko Prekmurcev naselilo v Betlehemu. Tu so bili zelo ugodni pogoji za kmetijstvo. S kmetijstvom so se priseljenci ukvarjali že v svojih rodnih krajih. Zato jih je ta pokrajina zelo spominjala na domači kraj. V Betlehemu so ostali tudi zaradi tega, ker je bilo mesto z železnico povezano z newyorškim pristaniščem, kjer so se izkrcali iz ladij. Betlehem slavi kot staro mesto z znamenitimi zgradbami in ostalimi ostanki najstarejših priseljencev. Nasilje so leta 1741 ustanovili priseljenci iz Moravske in Češke in je bilo vaška verska komuna, katere osnova sta bila verski nauk, cilj pa pokristjanjevanje tam živečih indijancev. Eden prvih prekmurcev v južnem Betlehemu, Jožef Prilec, se je tam naselil že leta 1893. Na to so sledili še drugi. Leta 1915 jih je bilo že okrog 7000.
Both my mother and my father were born here. My grandparents came from Slovenia. My grandfather Podlesek came from Srbobica. And my grandmother was a Vrečić. And she was, I don't know what small village, but she was in a small village near Murska Sobota. When I was in Slovenia in 73 with a choir, I actually had dinner at the house where my grandfather was born. And it was my cousin still lives there. My grandfather had one brother, Vincent, and the brother stayed in Slovenia. My grandfather came here. And the brother that stayed in Slovenia had three sons, and I met all three sons and spent time in their homes, which was really a very nice feeling.
Do leta 1924, ko so Združene države Amerike zaprla svoja vrata, so agenti iskali ljudi, ki so si želeli potovati tja. Ti so financirali tudi stroške izseljencev. Neka agencija iz Ljubljane je v letu 1924 ponudila Prekmurski banki provizijo $5 za vsakega človeka, ki bi ga napotila preko oceana. Srečanje z novim okoljem v tujini ni bil za izseljence iz Prekmurja in Porabja skok v prazno, ampak je bil zadnji korak včasih prav dolgotrajnih priprav, ki so bile rojene iz materialne stiske in potrebe. Želje nekaj več pridobiti ali se čemu izogniti. Zaslužki delavcev so bili različni, od 25 centov za začetnike do $2.45 na dan. Stanovanje je stalo od $11 do $12, hrana pa od $14 do $15 na mesec. Kljub slabim prejemkom so si uredili osnovne življenjske pogoje in poleg še varčevali ter pošiljali kakšen dolar v domači kraj.
My name is Betty Silva, or Elizabeth Silva. I was Elizabeth Bobich, and my mother was a Zrinsky from Ivanovce. I know that my mother learned to cook in one of the houses where she lived. She was only 16. And I never met any of my father's family over in Europe when I was there, but I met quite a few of my mother's family. And it was a pleasure to go to Slovenia to meet my family.
Jesam Stefan Antolić. I'm sitting here with Jozef Glashart and Stefan Čelić. On je mali vrak, jesam stari vrak. And I'm sitting in the famous Tally Hill Tavern, where my history of drinking begins. Because when I started Lehigh University, and in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, you can't drink until you're 21 years old. So finally, when I was 21, I came in and had my first beer here. So here I am, age of 87, back at the Tally Ho, beginning of my scenes of my first crime. In any event, Tally Ho is in Bethlehem, and the city of Bethlehem has a very interesting history. It was originally founded in 1741 by the Moravians, who settled here, and what is now South Bethlehem was just fields. And they lived on the other side of the river, which is now North Bethlehem. So they developed the lands on the south side by selling them off to people who made them farmlands. And at that time, you could not own property in Bethlehem unless you belonged to the Moravian Church. And they kept it very, very strict.
My grandparents came from the former Austro-Hungarian Empire. My grandfather's name was Gergar, Sándor Gergar. He was born 1890, and he came here August 1910. Actually, I have the papers from Ellis Island showing his date that he came here and the boat that he came on. He was from Krizovice, if I'm saying it right, which is the northeast section of Slovenia. And he also knew my grandmother, who was from, I think it's Kustinovice, which was maybe a few miles away, and they used to attend the same church. And they used to walk, one Sunday would be one church, the other Sunday would be the other church. She was born 1892, her name was Francesca Foyce. She came here in 1911, where she met my grandfather again.
The business little grew, and as a result, it needed many, many laborers so that the United States opened up the doors to immigrants to come in to work at the steel and work at the mines. So it was almost like, as I said before, a steam shovel came to Prekmurje and grabbed 7,000, 5,000 to 7,000 Slovenes, brought them over and dropped them right in Bethlehem.
My grandmother was working in a cigar factory here in Bethlehem, and my grandfather had a ash business, if I remember. He had a horse and a buggy that used to collect the ashes from the coal, and also had a job at Bethlehem Iron Works, which was the Bethlehem Steel, but it was called Bethlehem Iron Works at the time.
Večina prebivalstva na južni strani reke Lihaj je bila sestavljena iz priseljencev, naseljenih v neposredni bližini zaposlitve. Najprej so najeli sobo ali skromno stanovanje pri sorodnikih ali rojakih. Kompleks jeklarne je bil na ozki ravnini ob reki Lihaj, naselje pa se je širilo v položen hrib. Trgovine, cerkve, klube in vse druge objekte so gradili v neposredni bližini, da so lahko prišli do njih v nekaj minutah peš.
North Bethlehem, Moravians and the community of North Bethlehem didn't like that because they looked upon these people as foreign invaders. They're coming to live in their country and they considered themselves Native Americans. The true Native Americans were the Indians. But in any event, they were very strict and harsh on the people of the South Side, and they called South Bethlehem Shanty Town. The word Shanty Town means living in a pig pen.
Ko se je leta 1917 južni Betlehem združil s severnim, je imel 25 tisoč prebivalcev. 70% je bilo takih, ki so bili rojeni v Evropi ali pa so bili prva priseljenska generacija otrok.
The newspaper article one even mentioned that Bethlehem is so good that they allow the scum of Central Europe, meaning our people, to come live with them. So my mother and father, my mother came over 11 years old, my father was 16, so they were scum and were treated like that. So for me to grow up as a young boy, I felt second class, and that persisted. But they didn't come out and say it, but you felt second class because you weren't invited to join this club or that club. But they didn't say why. They would say, well, if you work hard and study and good, well, you can become a member. But they never invited you in, which made you feel, gee, I'm not good enough.
Well, the grandparents came over in 1903 from Borvetia. They came over in the Brandenburg, landed at Ellis Island. Stephen and Adam Dew, one went to the farm in Hellertown. My other, on my dad's side, he went to Bethlehem Steel for work. They had to have good health, sponsorship, money in the pocket. It was tough back then, but they raised some big families, like about 10 to 13 children. They raised their farm products, worked for Campbell's tomato soup products. They raised turkeys on the farm. And on my dad's side, we were in brick coat, plastering. did some electrical work.
Slovensko narodnostno ozadje je bilo vidno poudarjeno v reklamnih oglasih v časopisih, jubilejnih brošurah cerkva in podpornih društev. Bili so hotelirji, tiskarnarji, mesarji, krojači, peki, trgovci in drugi obrtniki. To dokazuje, da Prekmurci niso bili le delavci v jeklarni in drugih tovarnah.
Jaz sem Mary Karol, rojena Marija Peček, Krnce, Prekmurje, Slovenije. In sem prišla v Ameriko 57. Ne po moji želji, po želji moji staršev in moje tete. In moje delo v Ameriki je bilo v šivalni tovarni in te proti konci pred penzijo sem delala v domu na mogli v Kenji. In moje življenje je bilo zelo zanimivo po ene strani, zato ker sem nikdar ne imela želje iti v Ameriko. In končno, mislim, da ide vse po tekočem dobrom traki za mene. In zdaj sem v penziji, pa sem bolje zaposlena, kot sem bila, da sem delala.
V času cvetoče industrije je postal Betlehem središče težke industrije. Prvo železarsko podjetje v Betlehemu je bilo ustanovljeno leta 1857. Betlehem Steel Corporation je postal drugi največji proizvajalec jekla v Združenih državah Amerike. V jeklarni je bilo v tistem času zaposlenih 3500 delavcev, večina prekmurcev in porabcev, ki so izdelovali okope za bojne ladje, vijake, stroje, težke topove in železniške tračnice.
So basically my grandfather came to this country in 1919, worked at the steel company for 20 years, then he opened up a bar, was self-employed. My uncle Frank and my father, my grandfather had three children, Louis, Joe, which was my father, and his sister Margaret. My two uncles worked at the steel company, and my father was self-employed. All right, we currently own Saucon Valley Acres, which was built by this church in 1916.
St. John's Windisch Lutheran Church,
built. It was a picnic grove. The building was built by a gentleman by the name of Temlin, which was Slovenian. And the facility was basically used as a gathering place for churches to come on weekends and have picnics, polka bands, dance, and have fun.
Čeprav so prišli slovenski izseljenci v ameriške kraje večinoma kot nekvalificirani delavci ali skromno izobrazbo in so začeli svojo novo življenjsko pot na dnu družbene lestvice, so se začeli zelo zgodaj uspešno samoorganizirati. Ustanovili so cerkvene občine, nato pa v okviru teh tudi svoja kulturna in podporna društva. V to jih je silila socialna stiska.
So the two communities at that time, they became very friendly because in Bethlehem, anyone who came from Europe was unwelcome and they were considered to be foreign invaders. They got together and they formed a first Slovenska Bratovčina. It was the first Windisch Beneficial Society.
4. junija 1912 se je zbralo 41 izseljencev, ki so ustanovili prvo Južno-Betlehemsko slovensko društvo za pomoč bolnikom in pomoč v drugih potrebah. V njem so skupni cilj našli vsi slovenski priseljenci iz Ogrske, ne glede na versko ozadje. Ustanovljene so bile podružnice društva, v katerih so zbirali denar in ga pošiljali svojim domačim v Prekmurje in Porabje. Prvo evangeličansko društvo v Betlehemu je bilo ustanovljeno 5. septembra 1915. Katoliško društvo, Rimokatoliško slovensko društvo svetega Jožefa za pomoč bolnikom, pa je bilo ustanovljeno 4. junija 1916. Istega leta so Prekmurci zgradili svojo evangeličansko cerkev svetega Ivana, naslednje leto pa še katoliško svetega Jožefa.
Evangelical Lutherans went to St. Peter's Evangelical Lutheran Church, which was a German-speaking church, and some spoke German, and because it was Evangelical Lutheran, they then decided they wanted their own church. So they built St. John's Windisch, Evangelical Lutheran, while the Catholic people were at the Hungarian church, they didn't feel welcome. So they built their own church, which was St. Joseph's Church.
Prva evangeličanska duhovnika sta bila Američana nemškega narodnostnega porekla, William in Ernest Stigler. Za vernike slovenske katoliške župnije so skrbili slovenski frančiškani Svetega križa v Bridgeportu, ki so v Betlehem poslali Anzelma Murna.
Ja, zanimivo, lejte, ta luteranska cerkev, to je edina luteranska slovenska luteranska cerkev izven Slovenije, je ta v Betlehemu. In zdaj, če vi pomislite, da so iz tega konca, ki so prihajali ljudje, še v doma so se poznali, eni so bili luterani, eni so bili katoličani, in kakšna vera je to morala biti, da so v času med prvo svetovno vojno, ne, od 14. do... Zdaj so zgradili v bistvu dve cerkve, da so si v dustu trgali pa življenje takrat, ki itak ni bilo lahko, ne. Ampak je treba nam priznati, veste, ta zavest, ta trdnost in trma Slovencev, da hoče imeti svoje. Ne.
Leta 1916 je bil zgrajen slovenski dom, ki je v Betlehemu postal središče kulturnega in družbenega življenja. V obdobju po letu 1919 se je društvo delno vključilo v politično delovanje za vrnitev Prekmurja Madžarski na podlagi vendske teorije. Z raziskavami na temo, ali so Prekmurci Vendi ali Slovenci, je pričel Štefan Antelič.
My son asked me, Dad, you're Windish. I said, I'm Windish. I said, yes. He said, well, what is Windish? No one could tell him. No one could explain where the word Windish came from. Some people said there was a country called Windasia, and they gave it away for a white horse. So this embarked me on my study, and that study then took me all through Europe for 5 years, gathering documents in Hungary, Austria, England, Slovenia, even Croatia, and here in America, National Archive, till I finally was able to discover that the word Windisch was an old German word, Wend, so it was a plot just to keep Prekmurje territory from going to Yugoslavia.
Da bi v tem uspele, so mađarske oblasti pošiljale čez ocean tudi duhovnike, ki so poleg svojega poslanstva skrbeli za politično lojalnost mađarski kroni.
Mađarska oblast je pa veliko dala na to, da prepričuje te obmejne Slovence, da niso Slovenci, ampak da so Mađari. In tako je, ostajajo zelo natančni popisi, kdaj pa koga, pa kako so jih pošiljali sem te slovenske duhovnike, da so prišli v Ameriko prepričovati Slovence, slovenske rojake, da niso Slovenci, ampak da so Vindiš ali pa Mađari in tako. Ja, in to so bile takrat zelo take, tudi bi rekel na nek način, grde stvari. Ne? So ti Mađaroni prišli, veste, in se spomnim enega primera, ko je prišel temu duhovniku v Bridgeport, v Golobu, en tak duhovnik, in ta je hiter pogruntil, da to ni ta prav slovenski, in ga je enostavno napodil, in ta je šel potem v Betlehem in je tam stanoval v gostilni enega Mađarona in je potem iz tiste z gostilne štrene mešal temu našemu patru Anzelmu, ga je vse mogoče stvari širil, govorice neresnične in tako.
K zatonu vendske teorije o praktičnem življenju sta najbolj pripomogla tiskarnar in urednik Aleksander Kardoš in učitelj Aleksander Polgar, ki sta prišla v Betlehem leta 1922 in sta svojo zagnanostjo pomagala betlehemski prekmurski skupnosti, da je svojo energijo usmerila z političnega na narodnostno in kulturno področje. Poimenovanje prekmurskih Slovencev z Vendi je v angleščini potekalo vse do leta 1996.
Now, the true story. The sister city of Bethlehem and Wiskasoda is an accident. Why is it an accident? Very simply, for one reason. I was staying at the Signor in Martianzi because it was the closest Gastelnik to where my father was born, Norchensee. I'm there in the morning having breakfast, and there's a TV crew there doing a commercial. And who's doing the commercial? Gospod Salitz and Mr. Balazs. So he asked me, since I was coat and tie, and two well-dressed women at another table, asked me to join their table because it looked like a family. So I joined their table, and we start talking, and then they asked me where I was from. I said, I'm from Bethlehem. And the woman said, you're from Bethlehem? My God, my uncle is from Bethlehem, it's Frank Piff. And it was like home week. So we got talking, and I knew her family in Bethlehem. And then Mr. Tillis got very interested in what I was doing, so I showed him what I was doing. He said, this is incredible. What are you doing tomorrow morning? I said, nothing. Come down at TV station, we'll put you on television. And next thing you know, that night I get a phone call from the mayor. He said, this is incredible, because he knew about the Windisch problem, because in World War II, the Germans gave part of Prekmurdy back to the Hungarians. So he said, come in and see me tomorrow morning and we'll talk about it. So we got talking about it and we decided, how can we solve that problem? How can we bring the Slovenes of Bethlehem out of the Windisch mode and into the Slovenian family? So we talked about it, and it took almost a year and a half. I was already about 2 or 3 years into my study. So then we decided the best way to do it was to form a sister city. Because the word Windisch or Vend to Mayor Gettinger was a dirty word. But over in Bethlehem, the word Windisch was big time. And we set up a plot that he wouldn't sign any paper with Windisch on it. So I knew this was going to happen. So anyway, that night before the signing, he had him redraw the papers to make Windisch Day Slovenian Day. So, but had not Mr. Celic been there, there would be no sister city.
In tako je nastala zveza pobratenih mest Betlehem Murska Sobota. Na slovesnosti se je zbralo več kot 200 prekmurskih Slovencev in njihovih simpatizerjev. Za prvega predsednika pa so izvolili Franka Podlejska.
We wanted to make connections with our relatives and our background from Slovenia. We wanted to make that connection. And actually the whole idea was started by Steve. And then got me involved, and then between the two of us, we got the two churches involved, and that's how it all started.
I offended a lot of people because I was telling them that for 80 years they weren't really Windisch, they were Slovenian. So, but then the people in Bethlehem were lost to the whole world, because out 10 miles out of Bethlehem, no one heard the word Windisch. So people coming from Slovenia never came to Bethlehem because there weren't any Slovenes in Bethlehem, they were Windisch. So then by becoming Slovenian Day and having this exchange, all of a sudden we're now reunited into the international Slovenian community. So that's basically a thumbnail of the origins of Windisch, Slovene, and sister city.
I'm not Slovenian by birth or origin. I came to the congregation here at St. John's Windisch through Lehigh University. I was taking graduate courses there because I intended to teach, and I met my future wife. We married in 1976. We were both in our 40s by that time, so we had no children. We joined it, became a part of it. And in my case, since I was writing for a newspaper, or retired by that time, they needed somebody to take the meeting minutes and to make a newsletter. So I made up their newsletter for 2-3 years. And that was served as a corresponding secretary, a recording secretary, and then I've been on the board off and on ever since. But that's my whole story, really. It's nothing beyond that, and I enjoy it. As long as I'm able to, I will continue serving on the board.
Medsebojna srečanja so postala pogostejša. Prva spominska listina je bila podpisana ob 3. obletnici pobratenja v Murski Soboti, ko je mesto obiskalo 29 rojakov iz Amerike.
Veseli sem, ko vidim tukaj Števana Antaliča. Šter je bil prvi, ko je to začno. In ga moram gnes priznati, ko mi je bilo strašno prijetno, da sem podpisoval tisti papir v sodelovanju med Soboto pa Betlehemom.
Srečanje z rojaki je bilo ganljivo in marsikateremu se je utrnila solza.
We visited areas of Slovenia and it was the first time where I guess I saw all the old traditions, the buildings, the old haystacks. We took a little bus tour up toward Muska Sobota, but I never got a chance to visit the towns where my grandparents came in because we were pressed for time. It just hit home. I was able to see all the old traditions.
Venska teorija je vseeno pustila nekaj sledu. Na pročelju evangeličanske cerkve svetega Ivana je še vedno napis Vindiš. Kar pa je bolj materialni ostanek preteklosti kot izraz sedanjega čutenja potomcev prvih prekmurskih izseljencev. Veliko slovenskih izseljencev je pokopanih v Betlehemu. Tri pokopališča so, kamor jih svojci lahko pospremijo. Gods Ekre govori o viri združenih bratov, Nizki Hil izraža neutralnost, Sant Mihael pa govori predvsem o katoličanih. Svoj zadnji počitek sta našla tukaj tudi starša Štefana Antaliča. Slovenska skupnost v nekoč cvetočem industrijskem centru v ameriški zvezni državi Pensilvaniji se še ni sprijaznila z odločitvijo katoliške škofije Allentown, da med številnimi drugimi, tako imenovanimi etničnimi farami, zapre tudi cerkev svetega Jožefa, ki so jo v začetku 20. stoletja zgradili prekmurski priseljenci. Takrat je takratni škof Edward Peter Cullen zaradi pomankanja duhovnikov, sredstev za vzdrževanje in tudi faranov reorganiziral škofijo. Več župnijskih cerkva je bilo potem zaprtih in prodanih. Zadnja maša je bila 13. julija 2008. Odločitev o zaprtju so verniki sprejeli z velikim razočaranjem. Po protestnih shodih je sledila pritožba v Vatikan, da se škofijo prisili v odprtje cerkve. Le malo je manjkalo, pa bi bila cerkev prodana za $400,000, v njej pa naj bi svoje prostore dobil Center za mentalno zdravje. 7 cerkva je bilo kasneje na zahtevo Vatikana ponovno odprtih za občasno bogoslužje, med njimi tudi slovenska. Župnije pa so ostale ukinjene. Tako je slovenska župnija ukinjena in pridružena madžarski in slovaški, cerkev pa je odprta le za god svetega Jožefa in za pogrebe. Cerkveni ključar nam jo je le s težavo odprl. V 15 minutah, ki smo jih imeli na voljo za snemanje, smo se prepričali, da je cerkev, ki jo krasijo veliki barvni vitraži, ki so jih darovali priseljenci iz posameznih krajev Prekmurja in Porabja, v dobrem stanju.
Bethlehem has changed tremendously over the last 20 years. 20 years ago, Bethlehem Steel was the main occupation, the main industry in the city, and they closed in 1995 and filed for bankruptcy a few years later. 25,000 people worked in the steel. It was our largest taxpayer, it was our largest water user, it was our largest employer.
Danes je na tem mestu ob njenih ostankih nastal večnamenski prostor s kazinom, igralnicami in koncertnim prizoriščem, kamor so preselili tudi drugi največji glasbeni festival v Združenih državah Amerike, Music Fest.
Bethlehem of today, 2016, is much different than the Bethlehem of 1995. Our economy is more diverse. We became more in the meds and the eds, and we've been very fortunate that we've been able to make that transition from a one industry down to a very diverse community.
Bethlehem pa je tudi visokošolsko središče. Na Univerzi Lehigh, ki je bila ustanovljena leta 1865, študira okrog 7000 študentov. V letu 2010 je bila po oceni US News in World Report uvrščena na 35. mesto. Slovenci so se zadnji srečali na proslavi ob 20. obletnici pobratenja. Mesto pa je dobilo tudi prvega župana, ki je potomec prekmurskih staršev. Robert Dončec je zaprisegal januarja 2014.
My grandparents on both sides came from Europe, from outside of Mushka Subota. I'm very proud of our heritage, and we're very proud of our relationship between Bethlehem and Mushka Subota. The Gene Novak and his wife and the organization have done a fabulous job at maintaining the relationship between the two cities.
I think we have something like 168 people. I'm trying to get over 200. At one time we had over 200, but unfortunately we had some of the older people that passed away. My grandparents came from a Primorye region in 1909. My father was born here in 1917, and my grandfather spoke only Slovenian to me. Both my parents, my grandparents, their last names were the same. Novak, her father was a pastor, and my grandfather's father was a farmer.
Gene Novak in njegova soproga Kathy vesno skrbita tudi za medsebojne izmenjave dijakov pobratenih mest.
I'm sort of in charge of our students. Technically, it's not a student exchange because the Slovenian students would have difficulty here in the schools. Well, it's mainly the American students would have a bigger difficulty in the schools in Slovenia since we don't have students here that speak Slovene. We usually try to get one student here every year from the sister city. We pay all of their expenses, including their airfare, and the only thing they need is any spending money. So far we've had, I'd never counted, maybe 13 students. We have another one coming this summer for 3 weeks. We usually have them for 3 weeks. We make sure they see New York City, Washington, D.C., and Lancaster. A lot of them are interested in the Amish and the history there. We enjoy it. Nobody else volunteers to have the students, and we do not want to see this stop because it took a lot of years before we were able to implement it. So we try to stay involved like that. We love the Slovenian people. I'm constantly promoting people to join the Sister City Association, not just for the sake of saying they belong to Bethlehem, Mushka Subota, Sister Cities Association, but to support what we do and what we hope to do in the future. We enjoy it and we hope to continue it as long as we can. Gene and I are getting older, so we have to find some younger people to do this too. But we love going to Slovenia and hope to go back next year.
Marija Škrilec se je selila v Betlehem v 60-ih letih prejšnjega stoletja. Zdaj je blagajničarka Zveze pobratenih mest.
Kaj sem Marija Škrilec, kaj sem doma z Polane, Primorske Sobote, že živim z Ameriki 50 let, sem se prišla ga za 966. leta. Preliko smo kaj drugo gučala, ščim vse domače, pa sosedove, pa znance, pa sobočonce, vse pozdravim. Jaz sem ti blagajničarka, ti naše zveze. Mi dosta delamo, imamo vsakše leto piknike pa se, pa imamo kosila, ko lejko koje sredstvo dobimo, pa ti 3-4 krat na leto imamo avtobus, ko ide v igralnico, potom ti peneze dobimo. Ove dobimo od tistega, ko so člane.
Ob 20. obletnici podpisa proklamacije, ki je omogočala pobratenje mest, je bilo v Betlehemu praznično. Proslava se je začela na trgu pred mestno hišo s himnama ter dvigom zastav obih držav. Slovensko je dvigoval ustanovitelj Društva sestrskih mest Štefan Antalič, ameriško pa župan Betlehema Robert Dončec. Slavnostni govornik na prireditvi je bil veleposlanik Republike Slovenije Božo Cerar.
I would like to thank you once again for your contribution, devotion, your fostering American Slovenian friendship. Hvala lepa, thank you. Dobar dan.
Predsedniku društva Ginu Novaku je zahvalno listino župana občine Murska Sobota Aleksandra Jevška izročila Brigita Bavčar.
I'm glad to be here with you and honored to give our mayor a vote for for 20 years of Sister City Association Bethlehem Murska Sobota.
In memory of all of our immigrants who came to Bethlehem, South Bethlehem area.
Ob tej priložnosti so odkrili tudi spominsko znamenje sredi zelenice za mestno hišo. Ob njem so ob zvokih slovenskih pesmi spomine na obiske oživljali nekateri udeleženci potovanj v domovino.
We look forward to having that event every year. It makes our ties stronger between the two communities. And I think that in the future, we may want to see some student exchanges and really expand on the partnership that we have between the two cities.
V vseh letih je bilo z ene in z druge strani kar precej menjav študentov. Še več si želimo tega, predvsem zaradi tega, ker je v Betlehemu poznana univerza in osebno mislim, da bi bilo zelo dobro, da tudi visokošolski programi, ki delujejo tukaj v Murski Soboti, se povežejo s to univerzo. In to idejo bom predstavil rektorju Mariborske univerze in sem prepričan, da jo bo dobro sprejel. Vsekakor pa je naša želja in načrt, namreč drugo leto gostimo srečanje Slovencev v zamejstvu, ki se posod pravzaprav po svetu v Murski Soboti, in bom zelo vesel, če se ga bo deležil župan oziroma delegacija naših rojakov iz Betlehema.
It's nice to have an organization, the sister city, trying to keep the traditions up. It hits the heart, really. It makes me feel good and I'm glad to carry on whatever traditions that I can. And I really hope that we can keep the sister city going on with the traditional things that I grew up with, along with my parents.